Shortly after its discovery, the CRISPR-Cas9 system has taken the world of gene editing by storm. The CRISPR-Cas9 system has become the go-to technique when it comes to mutating and editing DNA in life science research. The beauty of CRISPR-Cas9 system is that it only requires two components: a Cas9 enzyme to snip target DNA, and an RNA molecule called the single-strand guide RNA that directs the Cas9 enzyme to the precise spot through complementary DNA pairing. In our previous video, we introduced the CRISPR-Cas9 system briefly. Here, we will go over the methods and tools available to you for using the CRISPR-Cas9 system in practice. We invite you to watch our previous video first before continuing with this one. Genome editing is achieved once the two components of the CRISPR-Cas9 system have been expressed in living cells. The delivery efficiency of the Cas9 endonuclease along with the gRNA directly affects the successfulness of genome editing. There are several methods to express these components in living cells, either through non-viral or viral gene delivery systems. There are two common non-viral gene delivery procedures available. One, chemical methods such as lipid-mediated transfection or calcium phosphate transfection. Two, physical methods including electroporation or laser-mediated transfection. Lipid-mediated transfection involves the use of cationic lipids or cationic polymers. First, the negatively charged phosphates of the DNA backbone associate with these positively charged lipids or polymers, forming a complex called liposome. The liposomes, which are essentially vesicles containing the exogenous DNA, can then merge with the cell membrane and release their content inside the cytoplasm. The advantage of applying lipid-mediated transfection is its high efficiency in a broad range of cell lines. However, that efficiency depends on the optimization of culture conditions of each cell type. The principle of calcium phosphate transfection involves mixing the DNA with calcium phosphate to condense the DNA and form a calcium phosphate DNA co-precipitate. The calcium phosphate also helps in binding to cell surface, and from there, the DNA enters the cell by endocytosis. Calcium phosphate transfection has been a common method since the early 1970s due to its inexpensive components that are readily available. Depending on the cell type, calcium phosphate may not be a suitable transfection method as it can have cytotoxic effects. In addition, reagent consistency such as a small change in pH can result in compromised transfection efficiency. Electroporation. As the name suggests, this method uses an electrical pulse to physically create temporary pores in cell membranes to allow foreign DNA to enter the cells. This method allows various types of DNA to be introduced readily into cells without limitations of DNA size. On the other hand, the main concern with this method is the substantial cell death caused by the high voltage pulses. The use of this method requires more cell numbers compared to chemical transfection methods. While the non-viral methods mentioned are generally sufficient to deliver foreign genes into cells, most of the time they are transient expressions and the efficiency can be low depending on the cell type. In order to maintain gene expression with high gene delivery efficiency, viruses are still the preferred system for many researchers. There are three types of viruses commonly used for gene delivery in living cells. These include lentivirus, adenovirus, and adeno-associated virus. All three types of viruses are required to be modified into replication deficit viruses in order to be applicable for gene delivery. Lentiviruses are single-stranded RNA viruses belonging to the retroviridae family. Lentiviruses enters the cells through the interaction of viral envelope protein and cell surface receptors. Once inside, they will stably integrate their genome to host cell chromosomes. Long-term transgene expression is thus achieved in target cells, which provides a major advantage to gene expression researches. Adenoviruses are well-characterized, non-integrating linear double-stranded DNA viruses that enter target cells via receptor-mediated endocytosis. They are known for their outstanding delivery capacity of foreign DNA fragments up to 36 kilobases, as well as their ability to give almost 100% transduction rates on many dividing and non-dividing cell types. Instead of combining its own DNA with the genome of the host cell, adenoviruses remain as an episome within the affected cells, giving transient gene expression. One important thing to note about adenoviruses is that they tend to cause strong immune and inflammatory responses among animal models. Amongst all recombinant viruses, adeno-associated viruses, also known as AAV, is the most promising candidate for gene therapy owing to its two properties, non-integrating nature and the lack of pathogenicity in animal models. AAV is also a very attractive tool in regenerative medicine due to its differential tropism that can be achieved with different AAV serotypes. For instance, AAV2 presents natural tropism only towards skeletal muscles, neurons, and hepatocytes. The downside of AAV application is its naturally small genome size, restricting its cloning capacity. The viruses offer a very simple procedure to gene delivery, allowing for high-efficiency transduction in both proliferating and quiescent cells. These viruses are often technically challenging and laborly intensive to produce. Efficient delivery of the Cas9 and gRNA into a living cell is required to carry out genome editing. ABM features Cas9 expression tools in the form of plasmid vectors, proteins, lentiviruses, adenoviruses, and AAVs. In addition to the wild-type Cas9 nuclease, ABM also provides the Cas9 nickase in all formats. So depending on your application, you can choose the best expression system for your research project. ABM also offers genome-wide sgRNA library ready for you to use. We provide individual lentivirus construct in a set of three, which will provide you three different sgRNA designs targeting different locations of your interested gene. They can be used separately or pulled together to achieve optimal gene knockout for your system. Similarly, our iCRISPR sgRNA adenoviruses and AAVs are useful for non-integrating, highly efficient genome editing in hard-to-transduct target cells. Although Cas9 and gRNA can be expressed from separate plasmids or viruses, researchers also have the option to use a single construct that expresses both Cas9 and gRNA. This could be helpful when working with animals or immune cells that are now very susceptible to gene delivery. ABM offers an all-in-one system with dual expression of Cas9 and gRNA in a single lentivector or lentivirus. Please leave your questions and comments below, and we will answer them as soon as possible. For more information, please visit our website. Thank you for watching.